It's doing good. It crossed $100 million worldwide, and on a budget of $100 million. So it's doing good, but we'll see if it. I mean, it's $100 million, so it's already made out the money.
I'm dying to see it, but I just can't find the time.
I just saw it today.
You enjoy it?
I actually really liked it.
Oh wow, we got some. This is kind of funny. We got some grouchy old Ridley Scott quotes about Napoleon.
Oh, really? Yo, I'm sorry, but Ridley Scott is the most funniest person in ever. Like, he's always mad, but he's funny.
Oh, Ridley Scott. Oh, my God.
Yesterday he was going crazy about those quotes. I was like, oh, my God.
I didn't see them all. I just found out about this right now. Did you know about this, Joe?
The man knows how to market.
Ridley Scott rips French critics of Napoleon. Look at that image too.
He's like, I don't give a F.
He isn't taking too kindly of French critics blasting his film, saying they don't even like themselves.
Damn. Wow.
That's based.
No, it's not.
I don't know if it's in the article, but there is a funny quote. I mean, this should be in there, talking about like the historical inaccuracy about Napoleon, and then Ridley Scott saying, "Were you there? Then shut the hell up."
To be fair, every movie is not gonna be accurate. The directors do their own spin to it, no matter what. So, you know, but that you're really. So
yeah, Did the French have the same energy for Luc Besson's Joan of Arc? I'm sure they didn't.
Probably not.
All right. Well, in response,
I like Exodus,
and Kings. He did that crap.
I like Jane Whelan's Joan of Arc better.
Oh, jeez.
Okay. In response to the apparent wealth of French critics targeting Napoleon, Ridley Scott seemed to take a swipe at the country as a whole, saying, "French don't even like themselves."
That is quite a quote.
The audience that I showed it to Paris, they loved it. Regarding negativity, the BBC cited La Figaro's review, said that Barbie and Ken under the Empire. Well, French GQ said that the moment that the featured French soldiers with clearly Americanized accents shouting "Vive la France" was deeply clumsy, unnatural, and unintentionally funny.
Wow.
When the BBC asked Ridley Scott if he had any words about those who were actively criticizing Napoleon's historical actions, the director said, "You really want me to answer that? I will have a bleep in it. Get a life, oh boy." Well, there was also Kylo Ren. What's his name? The actor's name?
Adam Driver
responding to someone giving absent questions on the Ferrari press tour. This has all happened since the strike's been over, and they said they were asking him about the authenticity of the driving scenes, and he says, and he's like, "How would you respond to us, some critics saying it's clumsy and bad driving scenes?" He's like, "F you."
Yeah, the visual effects, you're like, "F you." Wow. Yeah.